بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our case today also is real case from NICU regarding to neonatal lupus erythematosus. This case actually the history 5 days old full term baby admitted to NICU due to vomiting and red urine. Vomiting and red urine. After we take history from the mother, the maternal history is known case of systemic lupus erythematosus. She is on anti-epileptic medications. She takes Kibra and or Levetiracetam and hydrochloroquine. Antenatal scan, there is ectopic left kidney for the baby, and serology for the mother, there is anti-RO and anti-LA. Anti-RO is 106 unit and anti-LA is 34. The normal range for anti-RO, it will be 0 to 20 units, and anti-LA, it will be 0 to 20 units. So it came actually anti-RO, it's very high. Very old, 106, it's very high and will affect the heart. It will be more than 50 unit, more than 50 units. So the plan of care, the baby admitted to NICU, septic workup taken and started the antibiotic and urine microscopy taken, because this is urate crystal, or we call it pink diaper syndrome. CBC also to rule out thrombocytopenia, neutropenia. It's associated with baby delivered to mother with systemic lupus erythematosus, and liver function and renal function within normal also, because there is possibility for hepatobiliary system will be affected also, and ECG to rule out complete heart block, and echo to rule out structural heart disease. So baby to mother with systemic lupus erythematosus, you have to put in your mind the neonatal lupus is not like the systemic lupus erythematosus. Antenatal counseling, this actually during the pregnancy, there is antenatal counseling done for this mother regarding to the outcome, regarding to outcome. Just the risk of increase for stillbirth rate, it will be 25%, the normal, and also increase preeclampsia rate, it will be reached to 20 to 30%. For normal population, it will be just only 10%, and also the risk for IUGR baby, it will reach to 12 to 32% of the cases, and preterm deliveries can be reached to 50 to 60. Normal, it will be 12 to 15, but in this case, it can reach it to 60% from the cases will be delivered premature babies, and also increase risk for premature rupture of membrane. Neonatal lupus only in anti-RO, anti-LA antibodies positive. If there is positive, there is possibilities it will be higher to be neonatal lupus, to be associated with neonatal lupus. So the lupus pregnancy, actually the risk of the lupus to the pregnancy, either miscarriage or abortion, it will be higher with such cases. Or if no abortion, it will be what? Will be premature deliveries. If no premature deliveries, it will be IUGR babies, small gestational age babies, low birth weight babies, maybe lead to preeclampsia for the mother, and you have to terminate the pregnancy or to lead the mother to the expected management for delivery, and all these complications. So transplacental transport of the antibodies, as we know here, if you see here, this is the maternal, you see here, this is the maternal circulation, anti-RO, anti-LA, anti-RO, anti-LA, you see here, it goes to the placenta, attached to the placenta, so it will goes to, actually is anti-RO, if she is positive for anti-RO, anti-LA, 85% from this antibodies, it will transfer from the placenta, it will goes to the baby. And the 10% from the babies, it will be positive anti-RO anti-LA. And 1% from this 10%, it will have the symptoms and will be associated with neonatal lupus erythematosus. This is min rahmat Rabbina alayna. 85% will transfer from the maternal circulation to the fetal circulation through the placental transport. And from 85%, 10% from the babies, it will be positive for anti-RO, anti-LA. And 1% from this 10%, it will be infested with neonatal lupus erythematosus. So it will, the most affected parts for this baby, it will be cutaneous and cardiac. To see cutaneous and cardiac. Cutaneous 50 to 60% from the cases, and the cardiac, it will be 50% from the cases. But the cardiac, actually, the antibodies, it will catch it the atrioventricular nodes or SA node and catch it and maybe lead to fibrosis if long time these antibodies lead to fibrosis and scarring and actually lead to conductive defect and lead to complete heart block. It will be permanent, irreversible. Why complete heart block it's happening and irreversible? Because the antibodies will inhibit the calcium channels and will catch the atrioventricular nodes and will fibrose it, will damage it, damage these atrioventricular nodes, which will be damaged. Damaged, this means actually to permanent congenital heart or complete heart block. Complete heart block. Complete heart block, actually, it will be diagnosed in the second trimester. And as I mentioned before, 85% of the mother have anti-RO, anti-LA antibodies transfer to the baby circulation. So 10% it will get this anti-RO, anti-LA, and 1% will be infested with neonatal lupus, cardiac and cutaneous, and 2H hepatobiliary and hematological disorder. Mothers with anti-RO, anti-LA have 1 to 2% risk of complete heart block, and the recurrence rate, actually the next pregnancy, if she has baby with a complete heart block due to anti-RO anti-LA and she get pregnant next time, and the recurrence rate, it will be 10 times the risk. Of 1 to 2, it will be 10 to 20%. If the risk 1 to 3%, it will be 10 actually to 30% next pregnancy that the baby will have complete congenital heart block. Maternal heart, actually it will be not affected, complete block in the day 7, it will be rapid fibrosis. It lead to what? The fibrosis, it will be actually lead to damage of the atrioventricular nodes, lead to complete heart block. Antenatal, for sure you have to counsel the parents antenatally between or the second trimester. The mother was anti-RO, anti-LA, you will tell her. If she you did for her the screen and came positive, you will tell her, please, this patient need or your baby need fetal echo and need a fetal electrocardiography through the echocardiography, and actually we need vitally and weekly fetal heart rate checking, and there is possibility to start dexamethasone or not based on that condition. If we'll deliver premature babies, you have to start dexamethasone. And also the another benefit, the dexamethasone or hydrochloroquine will decrease the risk of the complete heart block. Also serial ultrasound to check the fetal growth, because this baby will liable for low-birth weight, IUGR, and all of this. And you have to do either weekly or 2 weekly, depend on the risk and depend on the anti-RO anti-LA. It's low risk or moderate risk or high risk. Neonatal lupus, for sure the baby will be infested with cutaneous and cardiac. Cutaneous and cardiac. Cutaneous, thrombocytopenia, hepatitis, hemolytic anemia, all this transient. It will be transient. But complete heart block, it will be permanent. Why permanent? Because the antibodies, it will catch the atrioventricular node and will damage it. And actually would lead to fibrotic. It will be fibrotic actually. So it will be permanent complete heart block. This baby will need pacemaker later on. Only if the anti-RO, anti-LA or SS, called Sjögren syndrome A and Sjögren syndrome P, SSA, SSP antibodies, 25% risk of the rash and the recurrence will be 25%. The complete heart block with the risk, it will be less than 3%, 1 to 2. And recurrent risk, it will be the 10 times. If the risk is 1, the 10 times it will be 10. If the risk is 2%, it will be the next pregnancy, it will be 20%. So complete heart block, SSA or SSP, call it S is mean Sjögren syndrome, A or NP, SSA, SSP or anti-RO, anti-LA. If there is positive, increase the risk. Increase the risk. If there is a previous child with heart block before, the risk will increase tenfold. If the risk of complete heart block is 2% or less than 3%, it will be tenfold. It will be 10 to 30% for next pregnancy the baby will have in complete heart block. Dexamethasone and hydrochloroquine, this is the medications for mother with systemic lupus, it will decrease the risk of what? Of complete heart block. This is the fetal echo, antenatal. It will show fetal PR, prolonged PR. It will give you clue this baby liable for complete heart block. This is also the fetal echo. So the fetal complete heart block, the mortality rate, you have to tell the parents and counsel them regarding the mortality rate. It can reach it to 25% and 90% of the survival after the neonatal period. And you have to screen it for anti-ro and anti-la, and you have to tell them the risk factor for complete heart block. It will be previous child with complete heart block. It will be 10 times if the risk is 1 to 3%. It will be 10 to 30%. Actually, it will be 10 times this baby liable for complete heart block. You have to tell them high titer of SS. A antibodies, it will be more than 1 to 16%. 1 to 16, it will increase risk of the fetal complete heart block. And you have to tell if there is positive anti-RO, anti-LA, or SSA or SSP, it increase also the risk of the complete heart block. Also, the maternal human leukocytic antigen, also DR3, if positive, it will increase the risk. This is antenatal follow-up, really is very magic, based on the anti-RO anti-LA. If you will see here, this is ELISA, and we screen it the antenatally. There is anti-RO, it's positive. You have to do another test, a specific test. We call it 52 KD. We call it ribonucleoprotein. It's more specific for cutaneous for the cardiac disease. If anti-RO is positive, so if negative, this is it will be low risk for the cardiac complete congenital heart block. It will be less than 2%, and you have to follow this patient by fetal echo alternative weeks, every 2 weeks, during from 16 to 20 to 36 weeks of gestation. If anti-LA, if positive, actually this is moderate risk. The risk, it will be 2 to 5% of the complete heart block, and you have to do fetal echo and weekly, not to every other week. Not this is other one is low risk, is every other week, but here you have to do weekly, and you can start the screening from 16 to 26 weeks actually gestational age. If anti-LA positive, you see this is moderate risk. This means 2 to 5% the risk of complete heart block, and you have to do fetal echo for this patient every week during the 16 to 26 weeks. Gestational age. If anti-RO negative, خلاص, this means no risk. Anti-RO anti-LA is negative, خلاص, no risk. If this previous baby with anti-RO anti-LA or neonatal lupus erythematosus, the risk, it will be higher risk, it will be 10 folds. Can risk of complete heart block, it will be 15 to 30%, and this one you have to follow this patient actually weekly by ultrasound or fetal echo from 16 gestation to 36 gestation. So in summary, you have low risk, moderate risk, high risk. Low risk, if the anti-RO is positive, I have to do another specific test. We call it KD, or 50 or 60 KD. This is more specific. It will be, if negative, this is low risk. I have to follow my patient every other week. And every 2 weeks, I have to do fetal echo between 16 to 36. If this KD, 60 KD positive, this mean moderate risk, 2 to 5% risk for complete heart block. I have to do fetal echo actually every week between 16 to 26 week gestations. If anti-LA is positive, this is moderate. Anti-LA positive, this is means moderate risk, 2 to 5% risk for complete heart block. You have to do fetal echo on weekly base from 16 to 26 weeks gestations. If anti-RO anti-LA negative, خلاص, this is no risk. If there is previous baby with neonatal lupus, this is mean high risk. This is mean the incidence of complete heart block, it can reach 15 to 30% from the case. So I have to follow this patient weekly echo between 16 to 36. Low risk every 2 weeks, I will do echo between 16 to 36. Moderate risk, I have to do weekly echo between 16 to 26. If high risk, I have to do echo weekly also between 16 to 36. So cardiac assessment, either electrical or mechanical or structural. I have to rule out any arrhythmia, complete heart block, or mechanically cardiomyopathy, or structurally if there is ACD and VCD and BDA. This is cutaneous lesion. This is, as I mentioned to you, the cutaneous the neonatal lupus. It will be 2C and 2H. 2C, cutaneous lupus, and cardiac. And the cutaneous, it will be 50 to 60% from the case. And the cardiac, it will be 50% from the case. And the hepatobiliary and hematology. Hepatobiliary and hematology. This is anemia and neutropenia and thrombocytopenia. This is the most common. It will be 50 to 60% from the case. The baby will present in the first week with cutaneous lesion. It can be periurical or preorbital. So this is pregnancy complication. The mother can presented with preeclampsia, fetal losses, and preterm deliveries and low birth deliveries. This is one of the complications during pregnancy. If the preeclampsia happen, actually, you have to terminate the pregnancy, or you have to do the expected management of the delivery. You have to let the mother to deliver. But you can delay the delivery for if less than 34 weeks to give steroid for lung maturations. I have to counsel the parents regarding there is possibility for pregnancy loss or miscarriage. It will be actually before 20 weeks, before 20 weeks. And most commonly, form of average about 20% from the cases, and the still percent it will be 11% from the cases. And put in your mind, neonatal lupus, and this due to complete heart block, because anti-RO, anti-LA, it will be, this is the main cause of disease. For sure, can be miscarriage, can be fetal disease, can be premature deliveries, and premature deliveries, severe stress can lead to release of hormone that cause uterine contraction. Why is the preterm delivery happen? Due to stress. Stress, it will release hormone, it will make it uterine contraction, actually make it uterine contraction. Another counseling, you have to tell the mother of the systemic lupus, there is possibility for low birth weight. It will be less than 2.5. And actually, the cause of low birth weight or small gestational age is due to glucocorticoids. It can lead to growth restrictions. This is the recommendation before delivery, and you have to counsel the mother regarding the systemic lupus and the possibilities of the complication of the pregnancy. First of all, you have to counsel her to continue the hydrochloroquines under observations and consultation of the rheumatologist evaluations, because the hydrochloroquine and the corticosteroid will decrease the risk of complete heart block. If there is any possibility of antiphospholipid antibodies also, it will be associated with autoimmune disease. There is any possibility that rheumatologist will start the thromboprophylaxis for the mother or no. You have to tell her the fetal surveillance regarding the fetal echo are doing either every other week if low risk, and every week if there is risk, and if there is if moderate risk, if there is high risk, every week between 16 to 36 week gestation. Also, you have to continue hydrochloroquine, because actually it will reduce the risk of the complete heart block, especially if the mother having positive anti-RO, anti-LA. Delivery, for sure, it will be vaginal delivery. Unless there is obstetric cause, you can go for cesarean section. Neonatal lupus, as we mentioned, it occurred about 2% from the babies to mother with anti-RO, anti-LA, it's positive. We said transplacental, it will be 85%. 10% will be positive from the babies, it will be anti-RO, anti-LA. And the 2% from this 10%, if positive anti-RO, anti-LA, it will be manifested with neonatal lupus. Due to the placental transfer, and this placental transfer of the circulatory anti-RO antibodies, actually it will be after 20 weeks. It will be after 20 weeks, and sign of neonatal lupus, it will be include 2C and 2H. 2C, cutaneous manifestations and cardiac, and 2H, it will be hepatobiliary and thrombocytopenia. All will be transient except ده كومبليت هارت بلوك، ات ويل بي بيرمننت بيكوز ات ويل ليد تو دامج اوف ذا اتروفنتريكولار نود، اكشولي ات ليد تو سكارينج فايبروزيس دامج، سو ات ويل ليد تو كومبليت هارت بلوك. سيستميك لوبس كومبليكيشن اوف ذا بيبي ات ويل كومبليت هارت بلوك از وي نو، اند ذا ريسك اوف نيونيتال لوبس سبسيكوينت بريجننسي ات ويل بي 10 تايمز اف اكشولي 10 times it will be 1 to 2 the percentage of the complete heart block, it will be 10 to 20% the next pregnancy of the recurrence risk. As we mentioned, the cutaneous lupus, it will be the 50 to 60% from the cases present in the first week of life. Neonatal lupus, actually it will be like raccoon eyes, or in the pre, it will be pre-orbital. If you see here, this is pre-orbital, like raccoon eyes, raccoon eyes, you see raccoon eyes or owl eyes here. Medication, it will be safe during pregnancy. We mentioned during your pregnancy, according to rheumatologist evaluation and assessment of the mother before delivery, he recommended for hydrochloroquine, it will be safe medication during pregnancy and will reduce the risk of complete heart block. It's okay, antenatal counseling. Actually, you have to counsel here the OGR and neonatal. This is, it will be 20% from the cases. And you have to tell here the delivery, it will be vaginal unless there is obstetric cause. And also the breastfeeding is recommended even of the mother with systemic lupus. This is, can lupus lady breastfeeding her baby? Yes, no contraindication for breastfeeding for systemic lupus mother. The mode of delivery, we said, should be vaginal unless there is obstetric cause. You can go for what? You can go for cesarean. And during actual the delivery, it will be there is stress. You can also give her glucosteroid for stress. Neonatal lupus, we mentioned this one. It as we know, passive transmitted the antibodies or autoantibodies, it will be occur actually in some babies born to lupus mother with anti-RO anti-LA. As we mentioned, this is the antibodies anti-RO anti-LA. It will transfer from the maternal circulation. It will go to fetal circulation through the placenta. It will be 85% of the antibodies will transfer, but only 10% the babies will get this antibodies and will be positive. And only 1 to 2% from this one, it will be manifested with neonatal lupus. And 1 or 2% from these cases will be associated with complete heart block. And another 2% will be manifested with transient manifestation like skin rashes, thrombocytopenia, and abnormality or neutropenia. The risk for complete heart block or neonatal lupus, it will be 1 to 2%. If there is previous baby with complete heart block or neonatal lupus, the risk it will be 10 times, it will be 15 to 30% from the cases, 10 times the fault if the previous, if she has previous baby. And consider this mother high risk. High risk, why high risk? Because the incidence of complete heart block, it can reach to 15 to 30% from the cases. The anti-LA, if the mother anti-LA positive, it to consider what? Consider moderate risk. It means the incidence of complete heart block, it will be 2 to 5% from the cases. And I have to do fetal echo on weekly basis during 16 to 25 week gestations. So maternal use of hydrochloroquine reduce the rate of complete heart block and isolated cardiomyopathy. Fetal echo is recommended in cases of suspected fetal dysrhythmia or myocarditis, especially in mother with positive anti-RO, anti-LA, or SSA or SSB. Treatment if the discovered or confirmed this baby antenatally has complete heart block intrauterine diagnosed, you have to give dexamethasone 4 milligram per day, or betamethasone is given to the mother. It will cross the placenta. It will decrease the risk of complete heart block. And I have, if there is refractory cases to the dexamethasone or betamethasone, you have to do plasmapheresis or pacemaker implantation is needed. Neonatal lupus, but in your mind, is not systemic lupus erythematosus. But in your mind, is not like the mother, is not neonatal lupus erythematosus. This is a cutaneous lesion. It will be pre-auricular like raccoon eye or owl eye. You see here, this is a raccoon eye. It's due to actually if the antibodies against the 50 KD anti-RU, anti-LA and ribonucleoprotein are associated with cutaneous disease and cutaneous manifestations. What is neonatal lupus? We know this is not HIV, not leukemia, not cancer, is not contagious. What is it? Actually, it is multifactorial. It may be genes, it may be autoimmune, it may be immune regulation defect, or maybe environmental. Lupus and skin or cutaneous manifestations, actually this patient liable to be photosensitive. What is the photosensitive? Because the ultraviolet light, it will induce production anti-RO, SSA, anti-LA, SSP, and anti-ribonucleoprotein. Actually, it will be, production will increase if the baby exposed to ultraviolet rays. So it will lead to photosensitivity. This baby, you see, this is the photosensitivity you see here. This baby has neonatal jaundice. And after we put him in the phototherapy, this rash started to be appear. So we discover this baby to has systemic lupus, neonatal systemic lupus. After we put him in the phototherapy and this rash, we consulted the dermatologist. This baby having photosensitivity, my differential diagnosis, a lot of differential diagnosis, but he thinks this is neonatal lupus. We did for him anti-RO, anti-LA, it came positive, and we did after that ECG and the echo, and we screened the mother, she came positive. This is another picture of the rash. We call it dermatitis. It will be resemble the subcutaneous subacute cutaneous lupus erythematosus, actually like Miller rash. This is raccoon eyes. You see the cone eyes or owl eyes, عين البومة. It's very common actually, and the characteristics, this will give you clue this patient might has neonatal erythematosus. And this is another bulbous lesion. It will be actually, it looks like the neonatal lupus. You see here, this is cutaneous lesion also. You see erythematosus patches. You see, this is raccoon eyes also. You see, you have to do lab work for this baby. Lab work will do CBC and renal function, liver function, anti-RO, anti-LA, and also depend on the baby. The baby is if I know the mother is she has systemic lupus and the baby asymptomatic, I have to screen him. You have to do for him CBC and your liver function and also renal function. And you have to do ECG and echo. ECG to rule out complete heart block, and echo to rule out structural heart disease, and CBC to rule out thrombocytopenia, neutropenia, or pancytopenia, and hepatobiliary, you have to rule out conjugated cholestasis, and also you have to rule out any hemolytic anemias. If the baby asymptomatic, if the baby symptomatic and the mother asymptomatic, and you don't know the status of the mother and the baby developed skin rashes or bradycardia, and you did for him ECG and complete heart block, at the time the baby will discover the mother. الابن يكشف الأم يكشفها. فبالتالي will do for the mother ECG and do anti-RO, anti-LA, and echo, it will come positive. And there have been actual many cases. The baby, he came with bradycardia. We did him for ECG. There is complete heart block. Echo done. No structural heart disease. We suspect this baby might have anti-RO, anti-LA. We did for him. It came positive. So we called the mother. We did for her anti-RO, anti-LA. She came positive. She came positive. This is the ECG you have to do for this baby, complete heart block, and the echo, you have to do echo also to rule out structural heart disease, and combined with electrocardiography and the 24-hour Holter monitor to reveal various cardiac conduction disorder and different types of the heart block, and the laboratory investigation, pancytopenia, thrombocytopenia, and leukopenia, elevated transaminase, actually because there is hepatobiliary disorder. If you are in doubt, about the skin lesion, it's due to when you need a lupus or not, you have to do biopsy. It will come to you actually, it will be epidermal atrophy. Epidermal atrophy. It is diagnostic by skin biopsy. For sure, this patient we need scan screen. You have to treat with sun screening and topical steroid. How to treat baby with neonatal lupus depend on the lesion. We said 50 to 60% from the cases will having cutaneous. We have 2C and 2H. Cutaneous and the cardiac. Cutaneous 50 to 60%, cardiac to be 50% from the case, and 2H hepatobiliary cholestasis and jaundice, and the other one is hematological pancytopenia, neutropenia, and thrombocytopenia. So baby with skin lesion, this different skin lesion, might transient lesion, might erythematous lesion, maybe blueberry muffin, maybe permanent lesion, maybe telangiectasia, different skin lesion. So the treatment for this patient, conservative or just to add local corticosteroid. This lesion, it will be transient, will resolve within 6 to 8 months. Why 6 to 8 months? Because the antibodies in the baby, it will be cleared after 6 to 8 months. The second lesion, it will be cardiac. It will be different. Actually, the most common, it will be complete congenital heart block or complete heart block, actually. And sometime maybe first, second, maybe Wolf Parkinsonian, maybe actually myocarditis, endocarditis, pericarditis. What are going to treat this patient is cardiac. Depend, it will conservative management first. Unless the baby develop carditis, you have to start corticosteroid, carditis, corticosteroid. If there is life-threatening complete heart block, you have to pacemaker this baby. If there is any heart failure also, you have to treat and you pacemaker to do pacemaker for this baby. But mortality rate for cardiac lesions will be 19%. Why the mortality? Due to complete heart block and pacemaker, it will be almost 65% of the survival. Hematological disorder, baby has anemia, thrombocytopenia, neutropenia, sometimes pulmonary failure, maybe high coagulopathies due to antiphospholipid antibodies will be concomitant with systemic lupus. What are going to treat this patient? Conservative. And he will actually resolve it within 3 to 6 months. Why 3 to 6 months? The antibodies will fade from the baby. This is the maternal antibodies in the baby. Actually, it will be cleared after 3 to 6 months. So how to treat the anemia, how to treat the thrombocytopenia? Just conservative. Unless it's refractory. Refractory anemia, refractory thrombocytopenia, you have to add to give IV immunoglobulin. If not improved, you have to corticosteroid. And even if the anemia and thrombocytopenia is resist, you have to treat it with IV immunoglobulin and corticosteroid. Hepatobiliary, the baby will present with neonatal cholestasis, neonatal hepatitis, liver failure, and all of this. So what is your treatment? Treatment will be conservative. Unless is refractory or persist hepatitis, you can treat with immunosuppressive or steroid. But this one will resolve it within 3 to 6 months. Why? With feeding of the maternal antibodies. Because the maternal antibodies, actually, it will clear it from the baby. So need to be aggressive with this baby. It will be conservative managed unless refractory or the baby resisted the symptoms. Also, the neurological, it will be actually is very rare. So the home message in summary of this neonatal lupus is referred to clinical spectrum of cutaneous and cardiac. Cutaneous and cardiac. Cutaneous 50 to 60 and the cardiac 50% complete heart block and other systemic abnormalities like 2H, hepatobiliary and hematological thrombocytopenia and neutropenia is referred to mother with positive anti-RO, anti-LA. Condition will be associated with serious sequelae like complete heart block or pancytopenia or neonatal lupus skin lesions. Neonatal lupus should be managed where? Tertiary center, because this baby might need what? Pacemaker, might need multidisciplinary approach, might need nephrology, might need hematology, might need actually a lot of subspecialties for this patient. So should treat this patient in multidisciplinary team or multidisciplinary team approach and should be in tertiary central. At the end, I would like to pray for my colleague is going for exam, Arab board, Saudi board, and Jordanian board, and my colleague for neonatal fellowship. أسأل الله رب العرش العظيم أن ينجح كل زملائنا جميعا يا رب، وأن ينفع بهم. شكرا، سلام عليكم.